Hi friends, it's Friday evening and today I'm picking the last one of 4 kick challenge locks by Das and Bill Bacardi, and I've saved me Bill's lock number 42 for the last day. Very nice lock. Again, pretty challenging. I think I've picked it twice. The package for potty and for a picking beginner are already in the mail, and I hope we will get them soon. So, the package for TNJ with some locks is the last, and I hope to get it out quicker when I'm finished with this lock here. So this will go to TNJ. So I'm trying to pick it with this short hook and top of a kiwi tension. See, adjusting the light a little bit. Okay, very very light tension as always. And for the first pass, I'm just touching the pins. Okay. Get already a slight false set in here. Bit of counter rotation. Okay, and a bigger false set. See, okay, pin 1 feels relatively solid, 2 is okay, 3, okay, let's see, 3 a bit, okay, got 3 set, 4 looks okay at the moment, and oh, yeah, 5 is deep down, let's see if I can get something out of it, a bit, very careful, okay. Yeah. Maybe a bit more. Okay. Wow. Pretty deep front set here. And here. Count rotation on 3, I think. One feels okay. 2. 3 very loose. A bit of wiggling, and here it's open. So this was a lucky try. Very very cool. Maybe there's a T-pin or so inside. A very nice lock to pick. And I'm happy I can give this to Tobias and Julian. Sorry for tissue here. I cleaned up another lock yesterday. I was waiting for a delivery 6.5 hours at our company, and it was actually my free day and it did not arrive, but in the meantime I did finish my first challenge padlock, which actually is not really challenging. Surprisingly, it's easier than the stock one, but yes, it was a nice experience, and I hope the receiver will appreciate it. I won't tell who it is, but I hope you will see it someday. Okay, let's see, get the shim in. It is a little bended. Oh, and it is pretty tight here inside. Okay, but it goes in. Turn the keys a bit, the core a bit. Okay. I hope this will work. Let's see, our pins are on this side. Okay. Very carefully cutting this. Okay. Oh, very nice. A lot smoother than I expected. Okay. Hope you can see it. Here's light threading. Chamber number 1. Threading in 4 and in also in 6. 2, 3 and 5 are not threaded. So let's get... Oh! Again, very cool pins from Bill Bacardi here. I will show them in detail, but a nice a mix of spool and serrations. Here a standard pin and tree. I wish I could make such beautiful challenge pins, but I still have not the experience. Oh, very, very thin rim. I will show the pins in detail. And here, six again. Beautiful. Yeah. Hope you can see it well. All the serrations. Here's the kiwi from the front. You can see how I have to work. Can very nice work from this white ledge here. So, okay. Shimmel out. Let's see what you can find here inside the Bible. Okay, one. One is an Esser spool. Oh, very cool. this is a double spool with very thin rims. And here again, you can see my cheap Sitex tweezers, which are very, very good, and I've just ordered two more of them. Maybe I'm giving some away, I don't know, still. A cool serrated one here in chamber number two. And a little copper spring. On the challenge log I made yesterday, I did a lot of mistakes. but, as I said, I'm still learning. Here a nice spool. Smaller copper spring, very nice. Oh, very nice. Serrations here. Oh, mistake. I will shove it back in. First one to get the spring out. A small steel spring here, as short as the copper spring. So let's get out here. Number five. Oh, okay. I will show you this in detail. There's a spring on this pin. It's a backwards T-pin with a spring. I'm very curious. Oh, what is this here? There's a wafer above the spring, so it's a spring-loaded pin. Oh, I could feel some spring action going on, but wow, this is a cool idea. I had no idea, and yeah, here's the spring, which goes on top of it. This is a cool idea. Oh, and a T-pin, as I said. Here's a T-pin in the back. I could really feel this. And a nice copper spring. I don't expect something to find in the Bible. No, Bible is stock, there's nothing done. The front is marked. So let's zoom in on the pins. Beautiful look. Wow. And Bill Bacardi is really a master here. Of course he's a master locksmith. Yeah, beautiful spool with some serrations on this key pin. And here the Arthur spool. You can see these spooled parts and the very, very thin rim. A perfect pin if you have some serrations in the core. And here, cool, cool angled spool. Let's keep in number two and a nice double serrated slash spool. I think this is more serrated than spool. Key pin number three is a standard and the driver is a standard spool. And here we have key pin number four. Yes, four. very fine serrations on this. Beautiful pin. And here again. Nice driver, if the camera will focus, with a very thin rim and deep serrations and a thin middle part here. Very catchy. Okay, keep in five. Again, a nice sharp rimmed spool. Hier. And I will show, yeah, I will show you this in detail. Wow, you can see it's a T-pin or something like a T-pin. Let's take a look. Yes, it's a solid pin, and the spring is shoved over this smaller end. And on top is this wafer sitting. Pretty cool. And the spring above that. I'm not that sure how this works, but it picks very weird. again, cool observations here. Angled in this direction a bit. You can see it a bit better maybe. And here the T-pin on top of it. Wow. Oh, this is really, really cool. sorry for the mess on the pinning board. Oh, thanks a lot, Bill, for making again such a nice lock. It was really a pleasure to pick, and I'm very curious how Tobias and Julian will work on that lock. And thank you all for watching, and see you in the next picking video. Bye.